I'm Leslie Wilkinson, and you're in my booth, Funky Fish. But you know where you're really at? You are in Brookings, Oregon for the 84th annual Azalea Festival. How cool is that? 84 years! Community lives here in Brookings. It's pretty cool.
My name's Matt Howland. I work with Travel Curry Coast, and we're here in Brookings, Oregon for the Azalea Festival this weekend. A big deal for us here in the county. It's a big draw for us. People come from all over the states to see us and celebrate the Azalea Festival. We have a lot of things going on down here on this side of town, as well as over at the Azalea Park. There'll be some bands going today. There was some dancing at the park last night for a dance party.
So we had this great DJ, Scott Graves, wonderful guy, another community volunteer that stepped up to the plate to put this on. And they were dancing. They were dancing.
My name is Scott Graves. I'm a longtime resident here and a volunteer with the Azalea Festival. We got everything going, and it's really a chance for the community to just really shine and show off all the great talents that we have here and just, I don't know, celebrate being Brookings.
Hey, great to see everyone out here today. Happy 84th Azalea Festival. I think Patty McVeigh's family's been here even longer than that, right?
My name is Patty McVeigh, and I'm part of the Checo Valley Historical Society. This is our annual Azalea Festival, which started in 1939. This area was claimed as a state park by Samuel L. Boardman, who was the superintendent of parks in the state of Oregon. And it's because it has so many natural and native azaleas in it. When they decided to dedicate the park, that they should have a festival because all the flowers are in bloom, and it originally started with a wild hog barbecue. That was kind of the big thing back then. And then it's just kind of evolved over the years.
Hi, I'm Janelle Howard, city manager for the city of Brookings. We have more azaleas than anyone else in the world, not just at the park, but in the Brookings area. But this park is definitely most of it. It is just a tradition that's now been going on for 84 years, so it is exciting. We were able to get the Oregon Heritage stamp about 4 years ago when we hit our 80th anniversary, and so it's just really exciting.
I'll tell you what, Larry, I can hear the sirens, the parades on its way. This is exciting. This is the 84th annual Azalea Festival, and we are getting ready to celebrate the parade.
I come to it every year. It's the best thing ever.
Hello, world! That's all I can think of.
Good morning.
I like the little Shriner cars. And my grandson was in the parade. He was holding the flag for the Azalea Festival.
Hey, are you guys enjoying the parade so far?
Oh, we're absolutely loving it.
Nice. So what's the Star Trek costume all about?
Oh, I've been a Star Trek fan for several years, as well as Star Wars, and I actually run the geek shop here, the Whimsical Griffin.
That was just what I was about to ask. I was like, you must be running the Whimsical Griffin.
Oh, yeah, definitely. It's fun seeing all the old cars, seeing the school and the kids get together, you know, the bands, just it's a whole community thing, and that's why we do it. We love it.
Can I ask you about what you were doing out there in the parade with the canines here?
Yeah, this is Canine Duke. He's a 4-year-old Belgian Malinois. I've had him for about a year and a few months. We've been on patrol. We're OPCA certified, Oregon Police Canine Association certified. He basically will react off of a situational awareness or my commands if someone was misbehaving at a level that meets the criteria for that. The parade today is a demonstration of Duke's ability to protect a handler or on command go after a certain individual, even amongst, you know, a crowd where I can call him off of someone and redirect him on another. It's for fun. I mean, in the real world, that probably would never happen, but it's kind of one of those calling things to work with an animal, a partner. It's a lot of work. It's super rewarding. I mean, this is best job in the world, man. Way to connect with the community, with children. Our entire canine team is funded by donations from the from the community that will cover food, veterinary bills. So we're just out there, want to connect with the community. It's literally the best tool in the world to kind of make that relation and bridge the gap between police and citizens.
Look at all that candy.
Pretty good stockpile, huh?
Yeah, you guys have done pretty well. This is like Halloween in in May.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Are you having a good time at the parade?
Oh, this is amazing. I love our town. Love our town. I am with the Azalea Quilt Guild. So all the quilts are made by quilt members, and they're a specific size, and they're to honor our veterans.
What an incredible parade. There's Lewis.
Howdy.
What'd you think of all that?
I think it was fantastic.
I thought so too. What does this area of Oregon have to offer?
We have our beautiful beaches, as well as the adventure out in the forest. You get the Siskiyou Mountains there. There's beautiful areas upriver. We're known for our wild rogue rivers. There's just so many beautiful things to do. A lot of beautiful trails, mountain biking trails, hiking trails. We have so many things to offer in the area, so many different destinations to visit.
It is a great place to live. It's a great place to visit. We have awesome weather most of the time. There's not a day that I can't get out and walk, and I love it. We have moderate temperature right now. It's about 60, 65. Sun's trying to break through, but even without that, I think it's pretty comfortable. So if you're over there in Medford and you'd like a break from that weather, we have nice, awesome 70 degrees.
It's just a different pace of life. I came up from Southern California, and we just wanted to get out of the rat race and live someplace that's beautiful. You know, I'm an outdoors kind of guy. I like to surf and kayak and fish. And, you know, you have all that here, but it's also the small town community feel. Your neighbors kind of know each other. They help each other.
The town of Brookings will welcome everybody in the county of Curry. We're glad to have folks come see us and see what we have to offer.
This event takes obviously a lot of planning. The city puts a lot into it, but a lot of volunteers really put a lot of time into this, so I wanted to recognize that.
When I was around town earlier today, just trying to maneuver around the parade and just how much everybody does a part that makes it work, and I'm happy. I mean, I'm very excited that it's turned out so well, and I'm just really thankful for everybody that does all the work.
This is not a one-person job or a five-person job. We just have across the board tons of people doing all kinds of parts and pieces and bringing it all together, and now we just sit back and enjoy our labor and just have a great time.
Volunteers rock in this town. Volunteers put on these events, and they rock. Without volunteers, things wouldn't happen. Because remember, this is just a town of 6,000 people. And some of these people are, you know, seasonal residents. So I think over here it's community, and we rock as a community.
All right, Leslie, really good talking to you.
Right, guys, thank you. Thank you.
The Azalea Festival was a fantastic experience. Brookings is one of my favorite towns in all of Oregon, and the community there made us feel very welcome at all the festivities.